thank you so much for joining us over the last 10 weeks. Can you believe it's been 10 weeks already? Most of you are gearing up for school now. We spent the first 5 weeks with concrete and cranes, where we were building a strong foundation on Jesus' love. And we spent the last 5 weeks at Everest VBS, where we were conquering challenges with God's mighty power. We've had a blast with family challenges, Bible lessons, songs, games, crafts, snacks, Renzo videos, jokes, Bible buddies, trek adventures, object lessons. You've just seen a couple pictures of the fun that we've had throughout the last 10 weeks, and I'm tired just thinking of all of it. So let's go ahead and do a recap of all that we've done over the last 10 weeks. We're going to start off with the theme song from Concrete and Cranes.
Foundation of love. The Bible point is Jesus chooses to love me and I can't earn it.
The verse is John 15:9. And as the Father has loved me, I also love you. Remain in my love.
On week one, we looked at Matthew chapter 9, verses 9 through 13, where Jesus chose Matthew. Jesus saw a man named Matthew. Many people did not like Matthew because he was a tax collector. Jesus loved Matthew and said, "Follow me." So Matthew followed Jesus. Jesus and his disciples were eating at Matthew's house. Some teachers asked why Jesus would eat with tax collectors and other people who did wrong things. Jesus let the teachers know that he had come to show God's love for everyone.
God wasn't eating though I sinned.
4, 5, 8. I did 2 times.
But God shows his love for us in that while we were sinners, Christ died for us.
Week 2, we looked at Acts chapter 26, verses 1 through 20. Paul listened and obeyed. One day, Paul was traveling to Damascus to hurt people who loved Jesus and to put them in jail. On his way, Paul saw a bright light. The light was so bright, it hurt Paul's eyes and he could not see. Paul heard a voice ask why he was hurting people. The voice was Jesus, and Jesus told Paul to go and tell people that God loves them. Paul obeyed Jesus, changed the way he lived, and told people what happened to him. He told them that God loves them no matter what they have done.
Week 3, a foundation of worth. The Bible point was Jesus chose to die for me.
The verse was John 15:13. No one has greater love than this, to lay down his life for his friends.
On week 3, we looked at Matthew chapter 26, verses 36 to 46, where Jesus prayed in the garden. Jesus and his disciples walked to a garden called Gethsemane. Jesus asked some of the men to sit in the garden while he went to pray. He asked Peter, James, and John to go with him. Jesus went a little further to pray about the plan God had for him. He asked God to help him and said he would do whatever God wanted. When Jesus walked back to the disciples, they were asleep, and this happened twice. Then Jesus prayed again, asking God to help him do God's plan for him. He went back to the disciples, and they left the garden with Jesus.
Foundation of promise. Matthew chapter 28, verse 20. And remember, I am with you always, to the end of the age.
On week 4, we looked at Matthew chapter 28, verses 1 through 10 and 16 through 20. Jesus made a promise. After Jesus died, he was placed in a tomb, and a stone was rolled in front to seal it. Two of Jesus' friends, both named Mary, came to see the tomb. There was an earthquake, and an angel came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. The angel said that Jesus was alive and was going to Galilee to see his disciples. The women were happy and hurried to tell the disciples. When the disciples heard the news, they went to Galilee. There they saw Jesus and worshipped him. Jesus told the men, "Go and tell everyone about me. Teach people to do everything I have told you." Jesus told the men to remember, "I am with you always."
Week 5, a foundation for life. The Bible point was Jesus' love was the foundation for the rest of my life.
The verse was 2 Timothy 3:14. But as for you, continue in what you have learned and firmly believed. You know those who taught you.
In week 5, we looked at Matthew chapter 7, verses 24 through 29, the house on the rock. One time Jesus taught a lesson. He said, "People who hear what I say, believe, and obey are like the wise men who built his house on the rock. When the rains came, and the river rose, and the winds blew hard on the house, it did not fall because it was built on a solid foundation. People who don't pay attention to my words are like the foolish man who built his house on the sand. The rains came, and the rivers rose, and the winds blew hard on his house, and it fell down with a big crash." Jesus taught this lesson to help us understand that God will help us know how to live.
Hi, guys. Wow, I've really missed you. It's been so many weeks. I was so excited when Miss Karen asked us to come back to say goodbye to you. Oh, every time I go by this construction site, I think of you guys. Remember the last time we talked? There was a big hole in the ground. Well, look what they've done. They've poured the concrete for the foundation and they've started the wood subfloor. But let's check and see if they've done a good foundation. I've brought my level and we're going to set it on this foundation and see how level it is. So the way this level works is
little bubbles in the middle. But when this bubble between these two lines, it's level. Look at that. They've done a good job. This is going to be a good foundation. So let's go back and see Mr. C, because he too was excited when he heard that Miss Karen wanted us to give a final wrap-up and goodbye for concrete and cranes and for Mount Everest too. So let's go back and see Mr. C and tell him that this foundation is level.
See you soon. Bye. Oh, Mr. C, Mr. C, this is so exciting. The kids and I went to the house foundation and we took the level, and the bubble was between the two black lines, so the foundation is level. Isn't that Mr. C?
Isn't that wonderful? I thought so.
Yes, it is wonderful. But Mr. C, it is 90 degrees out. Why do you have a winter hat and a scarf and your warm fuzzy slippers on?
Well, they said we're going to review concrete and cranes
right.
for VBS right. and Everest.
Oh, well, so we're just doing concrete and cranes, and Mr. and Mrs. Thomas are doing Everest.
Well, the Boy Scout motto is always be prepared, so I'm prepared. If a cold blast from Everest comes, I've got my hat and scarf and my fuzzy slippers.
Good thinking, Mr. C.
Yes, I'll be warm and you'll be out in the cold.
I'm always cold.
Yeah.
So, do you want to give me your hat so you can tell the kids a summary from Concrete and Cranes?
Well, it is getting a little hot in here. So I will give you all my winter garb, but I'm leaving my long johns on. So, kids, we're glad we can be with you again. And our topic in Concrete and Cranes was, how do you have a strong foundation in life? It's very important. And we had four lessons on that. So let's talk about it. Our first lesson was about love. And it was the love of God. And how the love of God is so great. He loves everyone. Everyone is loved by God. So make no mistake about that. Number two, forgiving. We can be forgiven of our sins. Remember, we talked about two different types of forgiveness. One was human forgiveness, and the other was heavenly forgiveness. Now, human forgiveness is what we do in between when we talk to each other, when we've possibly hurt a family member or a friend, and we ask for forgiveness. But heavenly wisdom is different, because heavenly forgiveness is the forgiving of your sins. And so when you sin, you can ask God to forgive you of your sins, and He will do it. He is the only one who can fully forgive you and take away your sin. The third topic we talked about was worth. How much you are worth to God. You are worth so much to God that He sent His only Son, Jesus Christ, to die for you. The most expensive gift ever of mankind that was given in Jesus Christ, for you and for me. And the last topic we talked about, to have a strong foundation, is the promise. What is the promise? Well, Jesus made some promises to us. One, that He would die on the cross for us. Two, that He would rise again from the dead. And three, He would take us to heaven when we die, because He has prepared a place for us in heaven to live when we die. So we talk about having a strong foundation. We need God's love. We need God's forgiveness. We are worth an incalculable amount to God, because of His precious Son, Jesus Christ, came to die for us. And Jesus Christ has made that promise to us that when He died, He would not only take away our sins and rise from the dead, but He would prepare a place in heaven for us. And these are the key points of having a strong foundation in life. Well, kids, thanks for spending time with us. We love being together with you, and we hope you enjoyed your time at Concrete Cranes, and that you've enjoyed your time with Everest, and we look forward to seeing you again.
Yep. Bye.
Bye-bye.
We want to give a special thank you to Mr. and Mrs. C and Mr. and Mrs. Thomas for taking the time each week to lead us in God's Word. They spend a lot of time studying and prepping those videos for you, so thank you so much for blessing us with that. We also want to thank Ms. Rhonda and the VBS team and our video editors and everyone who helped to make these videos possible so that we could learn more about Jesus this summer. And we want to thank you, families, for being so faithful for tuning in each week to learn more. So let's go ahead and have a quick word of prayer. Lord, we thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you that you are the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow, Lord. And we can trust in you. We can trust your promises, Lord. We thank you that you love us so much, Lord, and you showed us that love by sending your son to die on the cross for us. Lord, I pray if there are any that don't know you as Lord and Savior, that they would come to know you and have a personal relationship with you, Lord. We thank you so much for the families that have been faithful to tune in each week and learn more about you. We pray that everything they heard would be a blessing and that they would continue to learn and grow in you, Lord. We pray that you would help us as the summer is coming to an end to gear up for school and find ways that we can shine your love and your light to those around us, Lord. We pray this in your name. Amen. So let's continue our recap with our theme song from Everest VBS, My God is Powerful.
The Bible buddy was Climber, the snow leopard. The verse was 2 Corinthians verses 8, and God will generously provide all you need. Bye!
On week 6, we looked at 1 Kings chapter 17, where God provides for Elijah. God provided food and water for Elijah by having him go to the Cherith Ravine, where he drank from the brook and ravens brought him bread and meat in the morning and night. When the brook dried up, God provided by sending Elijah to a widow's house. When she baked the loaf of bread, her flour and oil did not run out.
Week 7. God has the power to comfort.
The Bible buddy was Cliff the Marmot. The verse was 2 Corinthians 1:4. He comforts us in all our troubles so that we can comfort others.
On week 7, we looked at 1 Kings chapter 19, where God speaks to Elijah. Elijah fled from King Ahab and his wife Jezebel, who wanted to kill him because he was a prophet of God. Elijah stopped to rest under a broom tree. There, God provided food and water for Elijah for his journey. Elijah went to Mount Horeb and hid in a cave. There the Lord spoke to Elijah. Instead of appearing in the mighty wind, earthquake, or fire, God presented himself in a gentle whisper.
What did we learn in week 8 of VBS?
God has the power to heal.
What happened to Naaman in the Bible story?
You have leprosy and God healed his leprosy.
What was our Bible verse this week?
He healed the broken heart and bandages their wounds. Psalm 147 and verse 3.
Can you show me the heart? The heart shows us that God heals us when we are sick or sad. Let's say the Bible point one more time.
God has the power to heal.
On week 8, we looked at 2 Kings chapter 5, where God heals Naaman. Naaman had a skin disease called leprosy. He traveled all the way to Israel to the prophet Elisha to find out how to be healed. Elisha sent a messenger to tell Naaman to dip himself in the Jordan River 7 times. Naaman was upset that this was the response he got, but he went and dipped in the river 7 times, and he was healed. God healed his body and his heart as Naaman believed in the one true God.
Hi, I am Autumn.
And I am Jeremiah.
Ouch! Sin hurts. But in week 9, we learned God has the power to forgive. Our buddy was Pike. He taught us our sins hurt God's heart, but he sent his son, Jesus, to pay for our sins. Just like our verse says, you are the God of forgiveness. Nehemiah 9:17.
On week 9, we looked at Luke chapter 22, verses 31 through chapter 24, verses 12. Jesus died on the cross to take away our sins and then came back to life. Just as Jesus forgave Peter for denying he knew Jesus 3 times, Jesus forgives our sins. Sin is anything that we think, say, or do, or even the good things that we don't do that does not please God. Sin separates us from God because he is holy and we are not. But when Jesus died on the cross, he paid the penalty of death for our sins so that we could be with Jesus forever.
Week 10. God has the power to love us forever. The Bible buddy was Yeti the Himalayan brown bear.
And the Bible verse was John 3:15. Everyone who believes in him will have eternal life.
On week 10, we looked at John chapter 14, verses 1 through 3. Jesus promises us an eternal home. Just like a circle has no beginning or end, God's love is forever. It never ends. It goes on and on. God promises that if we have a relationship with him, we will be with him forever. He is preparing a mansion in heaven for us.
Hi, boys and girls. It's the Thomases.
straight from Cape Cod on our vacation just to say goodbye to you. We hope you enjoyed these past few weeks, and I hope you learned something. We pray that you will be able to apply it to your lives.
So we had 5 Bible points that we covered over the past 5 weeks. The very first one was that God has the power to provide. God has the power to provide. And we saw that as we saw how God made provision for Elijah when he was in the wilderness waiting for the rain to come. The second Bible point was that God has the power to comfort. God has the power to comfort. So still following the story of Elijah, we hear how God brought him comfort and also provided him with a helper in the form of Elisha. And our third story that taught us that God has the power to heal was the story of Naaman, a man who had leprosy and was completely healed by being dunked into the Jordan River 7 times. Our last real Bible story and our fourth point was that God has the power to forgive our sins. And we saw how Peter, who denied Christ 3 times, still was able to ask for forgiveness from the Lord and receive his salvation. Our very final Bible point is that God has the power to love us forever. And we saw that as we read through the scriptures where Jesus told his disciples that he was going on ahead to prepare a place for them in heaven. And we know that in heaven there will be a place with many mansions that God has prepared for us. So as he takes care of us here on earth, he's also making provision for us in heaven. But the important thing about that, boys and girls, is that you must receive Christ as your Lord and Savior. That's the key to knowing and having the assurance of a forever, an eternity with God.
Well, we hope to see you soon in Sunday school. Love you guys. Bye.
So we have one final family challenge for you. We challenge you to build an igloo. Find whatever materials you have available in your house, maybe cotton balls, ice cubes, marshmallows, sugar cubes. Make sure it has a strong foundation, though. And we have a final joke for you. Are you ready? What kind of school do you go to if you're an ice cream man? A Sunday school. Get it? Sunday school, Sunday, an ice cream Sunday, Sunday, the day of the week, Sunday school. Okay, so we love the songs and the games and the jokes and the family challenges and all of the fun things that go along with this, but why do we do these videos? Why do we take the time and the effort? And that's because we want to help you learn more about the Bible and more about who Jesus is and how you can have a relationship with him. So we have a video that we'd like you to check out that will share a little bit more about how you can have a relationship with Jesus.
Hi, I'm Tyler, and I want you to know that God loves you and has a plan for you. God knows your deepest thoughts and feelings, and he wants to have a relationship with you. The Bible has a lot to say about God's plan and how you can have a relationship with God by trusting Jesus. So I'm here to tell you the gospel, the good news about Jesus, and explain how you can become a Christian. The first thing you need to know is that God rules. The Bible tells us God created everything, including you and me. God is in charge of everything. There is nothing that is outside of his control. The next thing you need to know is that we have sinned. Every single one of us. Since the time of Adam and Eve, every person that has ever lived has chosen to disobey God. The Bible calls this sin. Because God is holy, God cannot be around sin. Sin separates us from God and deserves God's punishment of death. That's the bad news. But wait, the Bible also has good news. God provided a solution to our sin problem. God loved us so much that he sent his son, Jesus, to rescue us from the punishment our sin deserves. That's something we as sinners could never earn or do on our own. Jesus alone saves us from our sin. Another thing you need to know is that Jesus gives. Jesus lived a perfect life. Died on the cross for our sins, and rose from the grave. He's still alive today. Because Jesus gave up his life for us, we can be welcome into God's family now and forever. This is the best gift ever. So how do we respond to this good news? We can receive the gift of salvation that Jesus offers us. The Bible tells us exactly how to do it. The letters A, B, and C can help us remember how God wants us to respond to his good news. ABC stands for admit, believe, and confess. First, admit to God that you're a sinner. The Bible says we all are sinners and that we need to repent. To repent means to turn around, to change direction, to turn away from our sin. Tell God you're sorry for your sins and trust him to forgive you. Second, believe. Believe that Jesus Christ is God's son and received his gift of forgiveness from sin. And third, confess. Confess your faith in Jesus Christ as your Savior and Lord. That means that you tell God and others that you've trusted Jesus to be your Savior and to be in charge of your life. The ABCs can help you remember how to become a Christian. But trusting in Jesus is something that's a really big deal. And that's very personal between you and God. So if you want to know more about it, talk to your mom or your dad or a grandparent or a teacher or your pastor. I know any of them would love to help you understand more about what it means to receive God's gift of forgiveness from sin.
Hello, parents and children of Everest and Concrete and Cranes Vacation Bible School. I'm Pastor Fisher, Grace Bible Fellowship Church's pastor. I just wanted to let you know how thankful we are that you allowed us into your home via these videos so that we could allow you to experience a vacation Bible school this summer in 2020. I'm really thankful for the staff that the Lord put together this year. Miss Rhonda and Miss Karen had a great vision and a great burden to have spiritual input for the children of our church and the children beyond our church who would not otherwise have experienced a vacation Bible school this summer. We're just praying that God use these Bible schools to help you walk in your Christian life, to draw you closer to Jesus. And we're also hopeful that if you didn't know Christ as your personal Savior before you started Vacation Bible School, that the Lord would have introduced himself to you and you to him during that time. Now, Tyler just got done telling you how you can know Jesus as your personal Savior and your Lord. I would ask, if you don't already know Jesus, please take what Tyler said very seriously and ask your parents, your grandparents, or a pastor about that if you have any questions. And if you'd like to contact us at the church, we'd be glad to help you with your spiritual needs. If you ever want to review these Vacation Bible School videos, they're going to be staying up online for a while, so please feel free to go back and visit some of the teachings if you'd like to hear again the communication of the Word of God in a very fun way. So if we can be of help to you as parents, the website that you have been turning into weekly also has the contact information to the church, and we'd be glad to help you in whatever way we can. Also, we'd also appreciate maybe an email from you to let us know how these videos have benefited your lives or your children's lives. And it would be really nice to see you on a Sunday if you decided to come and to visit us. Again, the Lord bless you and your life as you place a firm foundation for the building of your life in Jesus Christ, that God would help you to climb to new heights and meet new challenges in Jesus Christ, even as Vacation Bible School helped to explain. So God bless, and Lord willing, we'll see you.